He sold over 50 million records and had 27 top hits. It's country music legend, the original Rhinestone Cowboy, Glen Campbell, and he's playing.
That's a good song.
That's a good song. What was that one?
Rhinestone Cowboy. They're talking to you.
Oh, are they?
A lot of people say that.
Thank you.
Very lovely to see you.
This morning.
Yeah, it's great. He was rehearsing during the news. He was rehearsing his song that he's going to do at the end of the show. Sounds fantastic. And that's his daughter by the side of him. So,
Hello.
Good morning to all of you.
Good morning. Hello. Thank you.
It's a great pleasure. See you in a
bit. See you later.
Okay, dokie.
Fantastic. He has 70 albums under his belt, 12 of them gold, 4 platinum, 1 double platinum. He is the Rhinestone Cowboy himself, the living legend that is Glen Campbell.
Hey, did you happen to see the most beautiful girl in the world? And if you did, was she crying, crying? I can hear you. Wichita land. Lord, he's still on the line.
Everyone, a great song. And we introduce you as the living legend. And in fact, it is official. You are a legend. Because there is your Legend Award.
Oh yeah,
and this is from the Q Awards, mm-hmm. And you got this is on Monday, and you won the Legend Award.
I know, I'm very thankful for that. That's...
That is fabulous, isn't it?
How did you feel about being given a Legend Award?
Well, it means I'm getting older. No, it's fabulous. I do. I was really, really, it touched me.
Yeah.
So that's great. Well, and my wife liked it, too.
Of course.
Did you make a good speech? Were you allowed to make a speech?
I don't remember.
It must have been. What a night it must have been.
What a night.
It was a good night. Then.
You were saying, as we were just coming out of the commercial break there, that every time you come over, you get a great welcome, you love coming back, and you are very fiercely proud of your Scottish roots, aren't you?
Oh, well, yeah. I'm. You know, my dad was Scottish and my mom was Irish, and... The Campbells of Argyle in Scotland, they're the ones that come up and, you know, robbed from the rich and kept it.
And you still love going to Scotland because you play golf up there. St. Andrews, you
St.
say.
Andrews, yeah.
And in Ireland, you were describing some wonderful golf course there.
Oh, yeah. Arnold Palmer built one over there about 30 years ago, and it's up on, the whole thing is on the big, big top of the cliff. And looking off into the water, and it's just gorgeous, gorgeous place.
You are here actually to talk about your new album, which is out right now, called Meet Glen Campbell.
Yeah.
As if we haven't already, if not met you like this, we know your music. But this is a completely different side to you, isn't it?
Well, it's basically the songs. When I saw them, I said, "Wow, this is going to be fun," because it's a some from the Foo Fighters and, you know, the old rock and roll bands.
Yeah.
And
Travis, Green Day, U2, all these people who you've sort of put into your own style.
Mm-hmm.
Did you know the songs before you came across them?
I'd heard them, yeah. But that didn't have anything to do with whether I liked them or not, because I sat there and put it on the 45, you know, and see how I liked it, I liked it, and basically I try to make a song mine when I sing it, you know, so to speak. It's not greed or anything. It's just you got to have your way of doing a song, you know.
Well, Yoko Ono, I think, wrote to you because you're using a John Lennon song called "Grow Old with Me."
Yes.
Which
"Grow Old
don't
Along
know.
With Me," two branches on one tree. Yeah,
Yoko.
He wrote that. He never had been recorded.
Never.
Uh-uh.
So how did? I wonder how you got hold of that, or your producer.
She gave it to us.
Did she?
Yeah, his wife did.
Yoko gave you the song.
Yoko, yeah.
So there'll be people who've never heard it before. That's
mm-hmm.
Good right. Gracious. What a lovely thing to do for Pardon? Her. What a lovely thing for her to...
Yeah, she was marvelous.
But you have had some amazing, fantastic songs. Songs, Galveston and Wichita Lineman was another one there that you watched that clip go through and said, oh, what a what a song.
Roger Miller had a line which I copped off of him. I said, I've been around since Hitler was a corporal.
And you've got your daughter here as well, and so she's and your wife is obviously over.
Yeah.
So this is a full sort of family affair, isn't
right.
it?
Right. Well, when you come over here, you know, it's I like to bring them over because there's so much to see here.
Yeah.
You know, it's just it's wonderful.
And your daughter sings with you, isn't
she? Yes, she sings with me.
She's going to
there
be singing with you today because I think you're doing the Foo Fighters song.
Oh yeah.
You? Today from the album?
I don't know. You know, you get to, they point you and say, here, go here and do this, and then go here and do that, you know. And
well, we're very glad that when they pointed you this morning, it was our door that they pointed you
to. I am too.
Good.
Thank you so much.
No, not at all. Now, there was talk, just finally, Glenn, and I hope, I don't know whether this is true, there was talk of you retiring. Now, is this true?
I'd like to.
Would you?
Well, like I said, I've been out here, man, and I've been here a long time. I've been doing this since I can remember.
Yeah.
Actually, because we'd do a little events in the church where you'd sing and play and do all that. And I got one that we did in the. I actually got paid money when I was like 12 years old, at a festival thing, and I was the guitar as big as I was.
Yeah.
But I've been doing it ever since then. And I told my manager, I said, I'd like to just. Lay back or take off for a while, because I've been doing it ever since I can. Like I said, I was big enough to get on a cultivator, I was working.
Did your manager say no, Glenn? You can't retire.
Right.
You have to
he
continue.
Said you can't retire. You got to do this.
Yeah.
Well, you know how that works.
We've got a couple of questions
here.
We've got some questions from people. We went out to a local line dancing class, and there are some massive fans who desperately wanted to ask you a question. So here are a couple. Here's the first one.
Hi, my name is Sheila, and I wanted to know what you do in your spare time when you're not recording.
So what's the hobby?
Golf.
Golf, there you go.
Yeah, that's... Nice. I love golf. You get what you hit, you can't blame nobody. You know, you have to curse under your breath. You
know. And not always under your breath, I suspect.
I had to quit doing that, you know. So you can't get mad at yourself, it's silly.
No, and also they say, good gracious, is that Glen Campbell swearing out the golf course?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, you can't have that.
That's exactly right.
That's a cussing rhinestone cowboy. It's unacceptable. Here's your next question.
Hi Glenn, I'm Gary, and I just wondered, who was the inspiration for your music when you first started out in country?
Basically, when I could get on the radio, it was usually from like the Grand Ole Opry, and I also got a little bit of it up from a station, but it was mainly, I was just a kid then, and we didn't have electricity when I grew up, you know. We had to watch TV by candlelight. Anyway, we didn't have that, and when the old battery radio would run down, that'd be it until we could get a cotton crop going and buy another battery.
Really?
Nice. Yeah, we were poor, boy. In fact, we were so poor, the neighbors had me.
Glenn, it's lovely to have you here, and thank you. We're looking forward to hearing you at the end of the show. And lucky people in Cardiff and London. And I mean, you are doing some dates in the next couple of weeks as well around the country. So thank you very much indeed.
Well, thanks for having me. I really love coming over here.
It's a pleasure. Love to have you.
Thank you.
Well, Glenn is later, but we've got to take a break
Still
now.
Still to come, Glenn Campbell performs his version of the Foo Fighters track, Times Like These.
But first...
Jazz hands.
We'll leave you today with Glenn Campbell and a track from his new album. It's his version of the Foo Fighters' Times Like These. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
I'm a one-way motorway. I'm the road that drives away and follows you back home. I'm a street light shining. I'm a wild light blinding bright, burning off all alone. Whoa, whoa. you learn to live again. And it's times like these you give and give again. And it's times like these you learn to love again. It's times like these, time and time again. I'm a new day rising. I'm a brand new sky to hang the stars upon tonight. And I'm a little divided. Do I run away early and leave it all behind? Well, it's times like these you learn to live again. And it's times like these you give and give again. And it's times like these you learn to love again. It's times like these, time and time again. Times like these, you learn to live again. And it's times like these, you give and give again. It's times like these, you learn to love again. It's times like these.